हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज जो परप्यूरियम का जो नेक्स्ट पार्ट हमारा बच रहा था। तो हमने लास्ट वीडियो में परप्यूरियम का फर्स्ट पार्ट पढ़ा, सेकंड पार्ट। तो इसमें देखते हैं एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम। तो एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम में क्या चेंज आते हैं ड्यूरिंग परप्यूरियम। तो प्लेसेंटल हार्मोन्स देखते हैं। सबसे पहले एक्सपल्सन ऑफ द प्लेसेंटा रिजल्टिंग ए ड्रामेटिक डिक्रीज ऑफ द हार्मोन प्रोड्यूस बाय प्लेसेंटा। प्लेसेंटल एंजाइम इंसुलिनेज कॉजेज द डायबिटोजेनिक इफेक्ट ऑन प्रेगनेंसी टू बी रिवर्स्ड, रिजल्टिंग इन सिग्निफिकेंट लोअर ब्लड शुगर लेवल ऑफ इमीडिएट पोस्टपार्टम पीरियड। देन ईस्ट्रोजन एंड प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन लेवल डिक्रीज मार्कली आफ्टर एक्सपल्सन ऑफ द प्लेसेंटा रीचिंग देयर लोवेस्ट लेवल फर्स्ट वीक इन टू द पोस्टपार्टम पीरियड। द ईस्ट्रोजन लेवल ऑफ नॉन लैक्टेटिंग वुमेन बीइंग टू इंक्रीज बाय सेकेंड वीक ऑफ बर्थ एंड हायर बाय पोस्टपार्टम डे 7th। देन पिट्यूटरी हार्मोन एंड ओवेरियन फंक्शन। लैक्टेटिंग एंड नॉन लैक्टेटिंग मदर डिफर इन द टाइम ऑफ द फर्स्ट ओवुलेशन। The persistent, the elevation serum prolactin level in breastfeeding women appear to the responsible of suppressing ovulation. The woman who breastfeed prolactin level remain elevated into 6th week after birth. The serum prolactin level are influenced by the frequency of breastfeeding, the duration of each feeding, and the degree to which supplementary feeding are used. And prolactin level declining in non-lactating women reaching the pregnancy range by 3rd week. About 70% non-lactating women resume menstruation by 3rd month after birth. The mean time of ovulation in women breastfeed is about 6 months. The resumption of ovulation and the return to menses in lactating women is determined by breastfeeding pattern. The first menstrual flow after childbirth is usually heavier than normal. Within 3rd-4th cycle, the amount of menstrual flow return to woman pregnant volume. Then abdomen में क्या क्या चेंज आते हैं। एबडोमन मसल प्रोट्रूड ड्यूरिंग फर्स्ट डे आफ्टर बर्थ। ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट 2 वीक आफ्टर बर्थ द एबडोमन वाल इज रिलैक्स एंड इट टेक अप्रोक्सीमेटली 6 वीक टू रिटर्न ऑलमोस्ट इट नॉन प्रेगनेंट स्टेट। तो स्किन होती है वो मोस्टली रिगेन हो जाती है प्रीवियस इलास्टिसिटी में, बट कुछ स्ट्रिया उसमें रह जाते हैं। और जो मसल्स की टोन है वो भी रिटर्न हो जाती है, ठीक है, जो उसकी पहले की नॉन प्रेगनेंट स्टेज में जो टोन थी उसकी, ठीक है। और वो भी डिपेंड करता है कि प्रॉपर एक्सरसाइज पे और अमाउंट ऑफ एडिपोज टिश्यू पे। और यूरिनरी सिस्टम में भी क्या होता है कि द डिमिनिशिंग स्टेरॉयडल लेवल आफ्टर बर्थ में एक्सप्लेन द रिड्यूस्ड रीनल फंक्शन दैट अकर ड्यूरिंग द परप्यूरियम। यूरिन कंपोनेंट्स ब्लड यूरिया नाइट्रोजन लेवल इंक्रीज ड्यूरिंग परप्यूरियम एज ऑटोलाइसिस ऑफ द इनवोल्यूटिंग यूट्रस अकर। पोस्टपार्टम डायूरिसिस विद इन 12 आवर ऑफ बर्थ वुमेन बिगिन टू लूज हर एक्सेसिव टिश्यू फ्लूड दैट इज अक्यूमुलेट ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी। वन मैकेनिज्म रेस्पॉन्सिबल for reducing these retained fluid in the profuse diaphoresis that occur for the first 2 to 3 days after childbirth. Then urethra and bladder. If trauma to the urethra or bladder occur during birth process, the bladder wall become hyperemic and edematous, often with small area of hemorrhage. Then gastrointestinal system. एपेटाइट, तो बर्थ के बाद में मदर को है यूजुअली हंगर लगती रहती है कम टाइम पे। उसके बाद में बोवल इवैक्यूएशन, तो स्पॉन्टेनियस बोवल इवैक्यूएशन में भी डिले अंटिल 2 to 3 डे आफ्टर चाइल्ड बर्थ। Then GI or hepatic function. GI tone and motility decrease in the earlier postpartum period, commonly causing constipation. Then cardiovascular function. Most dramatic changes occur in the system. Cardiac output decrease rapidly, return to the normal by 2 to 3 weeks postpartum. Hematocrit increase and increase red blood cells produce stop, and leukocyte with increase WBC commonly during first postpartum period. And blood volume which increase during pregnancy is eliminated within the first 2 weeks after birth, with return to non-pregnant volume by 6 weeks postpartum. And cardiac output immediately after birth, the pulse rate, stroke volume, cardiac output remain elevated or increase for 30 to 60 minutes as the blood that is sent through uteroplacental circuit suddenly return to maternal system venous circulation. Then vital signs, temperature. तो टेम्परेचर होता है स्लाइटली एलिवेटेड हो जाता है 0.5 डिग्री फॉर 24 आवर्स में, ठीक है, और अप टू 30 डिग्री इज अननोन. द राइज इज टेम्परेचर इज ड्यू टू एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ मसल्स कॉन्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ लेबर. और जो पल्स होती है वो फॉल और स्लो हो जाती है, अबाउट 60 to 70 बीट पर मिनट हो जाती है, और नोन एज फिजियोलॉजिकल, जिसको बोलते हैं फिजियोलॉजिकल ब्रेडिकार्डिया फॉर 24 to 48 आवर्स तक. और ये किस लिए होती है कि आफ्टर लेबर रेस्ट करने के दौरान, और इंक्रीज सर्कुलेटरी वॉल्यूम ब्लड वॉल्यूम के कारण, और पल्स शुड रिमेन बिलो 100 बीट पर मिनट इफ ऑल द गोइंग वेल. ए रैपिड पल्स मे बी ब्रॉडली ओन बाई पेन, विजिटर, एक्साइटमेंट, एग्जॉशन एंड nursing infant hemorrhage or infection. Then respiration, this is the usual relation with pulse and temperature. Because of the reduction in the size of uterus and relaxation of the abdominal wall, respiration is more abdominally is character. Then blood pressure, no changes is counted, but if hypotension is present, postpartum hemorrhage may be susceptible. Then blood and fluid changes. Marked leukocytosis and thrombocytosis occur during and after birth. The leukocyte count sometimes reaches 30,000 liter with the increase. There is also a relative lymphopenia and absolute isopenia. Then respiratory function return to normal by approximately 6 to 8 weeks postpartum. And neurological system, discomfort and fatigue are common after pain and discomfort after delivery, laceration, episiotomy and muscles ache are common. And frontal and bilateral headache are common and are causing by fluid shifting in the first week postpartum. Then musculoskeletal function is generalized fatigue, weakness is common, decreased abdominal tone is common, and diastasis recti heal and resolve by 4th and 6th week postpartum. Then integumentary system, cloisma of pregnancy usually disappear at the end of pregnancy. Hyperpigmentation of the areola and linear nigra may not regress completely after childbirth, and it may be permanent in some women. And psychological changes during postpartum. Next is psychological changes during postpartum. Phases of maternal role. Emotional changes in the mother during postpartum period, restorative process as described by Reva Rubin passes through 3 phases during her taking in phase, taking hold phase and letting go phase. First is taking in phase or turning in. It takes 2 to 3 days during which time the mother first concerned in with the her own need, sleep, food and woman react passively, mostly depend on other to meet her need. Second, taking hold phase or taking responsibility as a mother It starts the third postpartum, the emphasis the place on the present. She becomes impatient and is driven to organize herself and her life. She progresses from the passive individual to the one who is command of the situation. Then letting go phase. As her mothering function become more established, as the woman enter in letting go phase. This generally occurs when the mother return home. In this phase, there are two separation that the mother must accomplish. One is to realize and acceptable physical separation from the infant, and other is to be relinquish her former role as a childless person and accept the enormous implication and responsibility of her new situation. Then bonding, also known as attachment, process by which parent form emotional relationship with the infant over time, influenced by many factors: family, stability of home environment, nurturing she receiving as a child. Then postpartum blues or depression. Postpartum depression definition is Rubin defined postpartum depression as a gap between the ideal and reality. The new mother self expectation may exceed her capability, resulting in cyclic feeling of depression during postpartum, and for no apparent reason that the mother can think of, she may experience a letdown feeling accompanied by irritability and tears. This depression is usually temporary and may occur in the hospital. It is thought to be related in part hormonal changes and a part to the ego adjustment that accompanies role transition. Discomfort, fatigue, and exhaustion certainly contribute to this condition. Understanding and anticipatory guideline will help the parent to aware that these feelings are a normal accompaniment to this role transition. Predisposing factor: the first pregnancy. The pregnancy is late childbearing year. Ambivalence toward woman's own mother, social isolation, long and hard labor, anxiety regarding finances, marital disharmony, and crisis in the extended family. Then emotional need of the woman during postpartum. Recognition of the effort made during labor, approve of behavior during labor as well as in the immediate postpartum period, supported and encouragement in her care of infant, attention from family member, particularly from the husband, someone to listen and help them solve their dependency, independency conflict, and physical need of the comfort, nourishment, and hygiene should be proper fulfilled. A good method to remember how to check the postpartum changes in the use of acronymous bubblers. Before breast, U for uterus, B for bladder, bowel, L for lochia, E for episiotomy, R for emotional response, S for human sign. Nursing management of postpartum period. Nursing care during the postpartum in providing the means during which the parturients can restore her physical and emotional health as well as gain experience in caring for her newborn infant. Then component of care during postpartum period: care of mother, immediate care, subsequent daily care, and care of newborn infant. Objectives of care during postpartum period is immediate care of newborn, secure physical and mental rest, restore normal good muscle tone and maintain normal body function, provide proper adequate nutrition, and guard against infection. Teach the mother how to care for herself and infant faster and maintain family ties and adjust the parent to their new role to encourage breastfeeding. Nursing assessment is the first hour after placenta separation and birth is under the management of labor ward nurse. Observation of bleeding sign and symptoms by palpating the fundus of the uterus through the abdominal wall normally. Inspecting the perineum and perineal pad of obvious sign of bleeding. Taking and recording vital signs every 15 minutes and observation of the leg for sign symptom of deep vein thrombosis. The sign of deep vein thrombosis is pain, warm, tenderness, swallow, redness, vein that feel hard and solid and positive woman sign. Then postnatal exercise is pelvic floor exercise, abdominal tightening, pelvic tilting or rocking, rectus gap, hip hitching and foot and leg exercises. Guideline for postnatal exercises is postnatal exercise is an important as antenatal exercise. It is duration need not be long, but it should be done twice or thrice a day. Repeated each set of movement about 10 times in every session. Keep the breath smooth, work gradually according to your capability. The physiotherapist may make modification to the exercise according to your physical condition. Then purpose of postnatal exercise is strengthen pelvic floor muscles to prevent incontinence, prevent lower back pain, speed up the restoration of body shape, stimulate blood circulation and enhance appetite and maintain vitality, self-confidentiality which help keep the happy mind. Then third is when should I start postnatal exercise after delivery? 2 days after normal delivery, you can get off the bed, the walk around and do postnatal exercises. Then some exercises is head lift immediately, back curl after 2 weeks, knee roll after 2 weeks, knee roll after 6 weeks and sit up after 6 weeks. And stretching and strengthening exercise after delivery in pelvic tilt, side lying leg tilt lift, side lying leg lift crossover and quadru arm leg exercises, leg rises and wall squat and partially curled and diagonal curled, the plank and dead bug.